So I'm in Warsaw, which is an international airport in Poland, and I'm in the McDonald's. And one of the things that's unique about Poland is that it's primarily a white Catholic country, but it's a bit sad because, except for some blue-collar workers over there, it really does look like this country is completely homogenous, even in an international airport. And so it's a little bit, it's probably a consequence of Catholicism. You know, just the idea of, you know, wherever the Catholic Church goes, they try to privatize or take a lot of the property within that country. And that tends to drive away a lot of people who are ambitious or who expect a fair deal. But, you know, ultimately, there's one person that doesn't look like she's completely white. But there's no other airport in the entire world, in a capital city or a city that used to be a capital city, that is this homogenous. And this is one of the problems that a lot of developing countries have, is that if they don't have a policy where they accept immigration on an incremental level and try to diversify themselves, they end up in a position where you know, you don't have that flywheel of not just innovation, but of immigration. And so, of course, the Poles are looked down upon by the rest of the EU. They're considered to be blue-collar workers. And, you know, that's, to me, that's not a bad thing, but the knock on the Poles is they're willing to work for less in the EU. And, of course, a lot of people simply focus on that aspect of the country. But the reason that's happening is not only because of a dependency relationship with the United States, given its strategic location, you know, within, between the Soviet Union and, you know, and the West, especially post-World War II. But, you know, a lot of that just has to be to do with the flywheel just not working in terms of innovation, which a lot of times is tied into, you know, immigration, getting new ideas and new things. And I'm telling you, like, I'm not joking. There's no other airport where 100% of the people are white. Like, usually, like, if you go to Canada, you know, you have a lot of immigrants, right? The Canadians are smart. When they develop their immigration system, they get the immigrants to work in the airports because it's not a job a lot of ambitious people want. But that gives you an idea of the way Poland is, you know, both aided and kept down by the United States. And so that's one of the consequences of having, you know, a country that is sort of in the EU, but still in a position where it's tied to the United States policy as opposed to the EU policy. And so here we are. Let's see what happens in the future with Poland. But this is one of the few countries where you really want to look at the immigration system. And even if the Catholic Church has a lot of influence, you wonder why they don't try to, you know, at least try to have South Americans coming here and vice versa. And again, that's sort of a failure in both, you know, public and private policy. Mm-hmm.